chapter number 6 of standard 9. Let's recall what we have studied in the previous lectures. We have studied about different plant tissues, that is meristematic tissues and then simple permanent tissues. In meristematic tissues, there are three types: apical meristem, lateral meristem and intercalary meristem. In permanent tissues, there are two types of permanent tissues, that is simple permanent tissues and complex permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissues are parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. So today we have to study about complex permanent tissues. Till today what we have studied, or what the tissues are, they are made up of same type of cells. But here in the complex permanent tissue, there are different types of cells which are present here. They combine together and they do a particular function. So here we have to study about various complex permanent tissues present in the plant body. So let's start. Complex permanent tissues are made up of more than one type of cells. As I told you that it is not made up of similar or same type of cells. The types of the cells are different in complex permanent tissues. But these cells coordinate to perform a common or a particular function, right? So this type of tissues are present in plants. Now where these tissues are present? So examples of complex permanent tissues are xylem and phloem. Xylem and phloem combine together and make a vascular bundle of plants. So we can say the vascular bundles of plant consist of two types of tissues, that is xylem and phloem. As we all know, there is a particular function of xylem and phloem. Xylem transports the water in the whole plant from the roots to the leaves, while the phloem transports food from the leaves to the whole plant, right? So let's see which cells are present in xylem and phloem. As I told you that complex permanent tissue is made up of different types of cells. So here the xylem consists of tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. So here are the diagrams of this cells: tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. They all coordinate between them and they perform a common function, that is the transport of water and minerals, right? Now we can say that tracheids and vessels, they have thick walls and they are composed mainly of dead cells. And they have a tube-like structure, as you can see in the diagram. Okay, so as they have tube-like structure, they can easily transport water and minerals from the roots to all parts of the plant. The xylem parenchyma has function to store the food. And xylem fibers, they are generally the supportive tissues, or we can say supportive cells. So all these cells, tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers, they coordinate between each other and perform a common function of transporting water and minerals. Now let's move towards the next complex permanent tissue, that is phloem. So phloem consists of mainly five types of cells, that is sieve cells, sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma and phloem fibers. So as you can see in the figure, here there are sieve tubes, phloem parenchyma, companion cells, phloem fibers, and they all coordinate between each other and they perform a particular or common function of transporting food into the whole plant. Here the sieve tube is tube-like structure, okay, or tube-like cells which transport the food to all the parts of the plant. Except the phloem fibers, all the cells, that is sieve cells, sieve tubes, phloem parenchyma and companion cells, all these cells are living. So this is all about the complex permanent tissues present in plants. Here we are completing the one portion of our chapter, that is the plant tissues. Now let's move towards our next topic, that is animal tissues. So in this chapter we have to study about different animal tissues which are present in animals, right? So these tissues are epithelial tissue, then connective tissue, muscular tissues and nervous tissue. As we know, in multicellular organisms, all the different functions are done by different tissues or different cells, right? So these tissues have their own function. They all have their own shape and size and they perform a particular function. So let's move towards our first animal tissue, that is epithelial tissue. As we have studied in the plant tissues, that epidermis is the outermost covering of the any plant. Like that only, epithelial tissues present in the outermost layer. Okay, so we can say the skin is made up of epithelial tissue. What is the function of epithelial tissue? In common we can say that it keeps different system separate from each other. So we know that we have different systems in our body, that is respiratory system, circulatory system, digestive system. So all these systems can be separated with this epithelial tissue. It is generally located in skin, lining of mouth, lining of blood vessels, lung alveoli, kidney tubules, etc. So all these are made up of epithelial tissues, right? Cells are tightly packed and they forms a continuous sheet. So the cells of epithelial tissue are tightly packed, means we can say that there is no intercellular space between them and they forms a continuous sheet. So whenever any substance have to enter or exit our body, okay, then it must have to pass through the epithelial tissue. As I told you, it is the outermost layer of any animal, right? So we can say that it controls the entry and exit of any material. So this is the main function of epithelial tissue. Now there are mainly three types of epithelial tissue, that is squamous epithelium, then columnar epithelium and then cuboidal epithelium. So let's see it in detail one by one. First, squamous epithelium. Squama means scales of the skin. Squamous epithelium is mainly of two types, that is simple squamous epithelium and stratified squamous epithelium. So simple squamous epithelium, it is generally located in lining of blood vessels, lining of mouth, lungs alveoli and esophagus. It is made up of only a single layer of cells, and here the cells are very thin and flat, right? And it also forms a delicate lining, means it separates each and every part of our body where this squamous epithelium are present. As the cells of simple squamous epithelium are very thin, the function of these cells are to transport the materials through the selectively permeable surface. Now, second is stratified squamous epithelium. It is generally located in the skin. So, skin is made up of layers of cells. As these layers are arranged in a pattern, then it is known as stratified squamous epithelium. So, the function of stratified squamous epithelium is to control the entry and exit of different materials. Now, the third is columnar epithelium. It is generally located in inner lining of small intestine. In the inner lining of small intestine, there is a function of secretion and absorption. We have already studied in the previous standards about the function of small intestine. So here, this tissue will secrete some substance and help in the absorption. So, this type of epithelium, that is columnar epithelium, means pillar-like structures are present in the inner lining of small intestine. When they are present in the respiratory tract of human beings or any animals, they are known as ciliated columnar epithelium because they have cilia-like structure on their surface. Cilia are nothing but the finger-like projections present on the surface of any tissue or any cells, right? So, as these cilia are present here in the respiratory tract, it will push down the mucus in the respiratory tract. So, the function of ciliated columnar epithelium is to push down the mucus in the whole respiratory tract, right? So, this is about columnar epithelium. Now, next epithelium is cuboidal epithelium. It is generally present in the lining of kidney tubules as well as in the ducts of salivary glands. These types of tissues generally give support to any organ or organ system. So these are the three main epithelial tissues: squamous epithelium, columnar epithelium and cuboidal epithelium. But sometimes the epithelium tissues, cells of the epithelium tissues fold inward. That's why they are known as glandular epithelium. So this is all about the epithelium tissues. In the next lecture, we are going to study about the connective tissue. Connective tissue means what? Which connects our body or different organs of our body. Say for example, bones, blood, etc. So, in the next lecture, we are going to study about the connective tissue. Till that, be at home, be safe. Thank you.
Aabhaar.